Hello, my name is Stacey Belkrin. I did my project on the Kingdom of Morocco, which is in North Africa. Morocco lies at the junction of the Atlantic Ocean and the Mediterranean Sea. Of the 32 million people that make up its population, the majority of them live west of the Atlas Mountains. To the east of it is the Sahara Desert. That area west of the Atlas Mountains, where most of the people live off the coast of the Mediterranean Sea, is characterized by really hot and dry summers and cold and humid winters. Because of its geographical position and its geographical characteristics, Morocco is very prone to many natural disasters, some of those being earthquakes, floods, torrential rains, desertification, and drought. Morocco's implementation pattern is a top-down approach. The national government makes the orders for the local governments and then so on and so forth to the citizens. Morocco has a lot of things in place to deal with a lot of these natural disasters. One of the ones I was most impressed by was their drought preparedness. The Department of Environment and the Department of Water and Ministry of Agriculture introduced programs for water recovery and incentives for people to save water and to use better irrigation systems and rehabilitate their irrigation systems that have been, you know, become antiquated. And there's also been a lot of financial support for agricultural farmers who do things like that. So Morocco has had recurring problems with the two extremes of floods and droughts. Besides that, more recently in 2004, Morocco had an earthquake on the north side of Morocco. The government of Morocco works with several organizations around the world, many actually, and there's also some cross-country relations that they have with some of their nearer neighbors. One interesting program that I wanted to share with you all was one that the government of Morocco worked with the World Bank and GFDRR to prevent the serious socioeconomic impacts of natural disasters on their population. Government reviewed a lot of the financial mechanisms that were in place to deal with people who had been affected with natural disasters. They really looked at the risk assessment and they made some changes to the places that they thought were more prone to certain disasters versus others. And they came up with a lot of community level resilience plans so that people could be prepared for disasters on their own before even the aid from the government came. Another interesting collaboration that the Moroccan government had was with the U.S. Forest International Programs. Morocco's forests are home to a bunch of endangered and unique species. So the Moroccan High Commission on Water, Forests, and Combating Desertification combined their efforts to make it a more ecologically sound and safe place for all of those species. 70% of the rural communities in Morocco depend on agricultural ways to get their money and to get their food and to feed their families. And they suffer a lot when there are flood events and erosion events especially. The U.S. Forest Service, as well as the UN Development Program, U.S. Peace Corps, and the Ministry of Equipment and Transportation, as well as local Moroccan associations, work together to help prepare for those erratic weather patterns and changing climatic conditions for the farmers there. Some challenges for the Moroccan government in their disaster management is, first of all, identifying which disasters they want to spend money on and which ones they want to spend maybe a little bit less money on, since they are so vulnerable to so many disasters. Beyond this, the obstacle of reaching the so many people that live in rural communities that aren't centered in Marrakesh or Rabat is a challenge to get to them geographically. A lot of emphasis is being put on erosion, flooding, and earthquakes in Morocco, especially after the 2004 earthquake. And with flooding and erosion, again, a lot of the economy is agriculturally based, so having a serial amount of years where they were constantly having to deal with flooding and erosion issues that affected their population so much, who didn't have insurance and things like that. That has become a major emphasis and a major part of their disaster risk management. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation as well as learned something and was stimulated by it. I can't wait to read your comments. Bye!